you can see that there's no or almost no blood flow going across the blockage here. This is what we call a carotid stenosis or carotid blockage.
The carotid arteries carry blood to the brain. Plaque can block blood flow, causing a stroke, the fourth leading cause of death, and the leading cause of disability in the United States. Dr. Brajesh Lal at the University of Maryland School of Medicine in Baltimore led a new national comparison of the two most common procedures that remove blockages in the neck arteries. His findings may challenge the current standard of care.
The whole purpose of first diagnosing these blockages and then somehow removing or relieving the blockage is important in terms of preventing the incidence of stroke. This outlines
the new study, the largest of its kind, compared surgery, the most commonly used procedure, to stenting to see which better prevents plaque buildup over time. In surgery, after an incision in the neck, the artery is opened, the plaque removed, then the artery is sewn back together.
Here you get a good view of what the stent looks like.
Stenting in the carotids is similar to stenting in the coronary arteries of the heart. A wire mesh placed inside the artery keeps it open. A previous comparison of the two neck procedures showed no difference in rates of stroke, heart attack, or death. But Dr. Lal says re-blockage rates in heart stents could be as high as 20% to 30%. Would the numbers be similar in carotid stents?
This was a huge surprise.
After 2 years of follow-up, re-blockage rates were identical, about 6%, whether surgery or stenting. The study also noted that re-blockage was double in women, diabetics, and those with high blood fats like cholesterol. And the rate of stroke was 4 times higher for patients who experienced a re-blockage. Dr. Lal predicts that with this new information, physicians and patients may take a closer look at stenting.
Practitioners will need to know how to do surgery as well as stenting in order to treat these patients in the most optimal manner possible.
I'm Bill Seiler.